Thomas Whaley was a very civic-minded New York merchant who came out here with the California Gold Rush. And when he arrived in San Diego, he learned to speak Spanish so that he could effectively do business with the native population here, and thusly opened the very first bilingual store in San Diego called La Tienda California. Thomas Whaley held many important roles here in early Old Town history. In addition to operating several stores, two of them right here in this house, he was the county clerk, he sold real estate and insurance, and at the time, San Diego's future economic growth depended on getting the railroad terminus located here, and Whaley worked tirelessly on the railroad committees in order to help achieve that goal. The Whaley family were considered prominent citizens and they were well respected here in the community of Old Town. Thomas and his wife Anna and their five surviving children, which were Frank, Annie, George, Violet, and Lillian, all built strong relationships with the community here in Old Town that they maintained throughout their lives. This house became a social center. They had theatrical performances, parties, dances, musical soirees that lasted into the wee hours of the night.
The Whaley House was completed not long after California became the 31st state in 1850, and it is believed to be the oldest two-story brick structure south of Monterey, California. It has been said the Whaley House contains more history within its walls than any other building in Southern California. The Whaley homestead was begun in 1856 with the construction of the one-story wing, which was originally used for grain storage. The rest of the house, the two-story part, was completed the following year in 1857. Originally, the downstairs was intended for business use with three large bays going to the back, where the residence was upstairs only. Over time, as Whaley's family grew, he moved residence rooms downstairs and the whole house became a residence. The Whaley House was the first two-story brick structure in San Diego at a time when most homes were small one-bedroom adobe structures. So it was considered a grand mansion in its day. It was designed by Thomas Whaley himself based upon homes he knew from New York in the Greek Revival style, which was very popular at the time. Thomas Whaley did a first remodel in 1868, changing the downstairs into residence rooms, the parlors and a bedroom and the dining room and such. Whereas upstairs was rented by a traveling theatrical troupe called the Tanner Troupe and became San Diego's first commercial theater. The following year, the county of San Diego rented the one-story former granary for use as the second county courthouse. Later, that same space was used as a billiard hall, a Sunday school, a polling place, meeting place for the county board of supervisors, and a theater. When Thomas Whaley first arrived in San Diego in 1851, all that stood here on the site of his future home was the town gallows, a primitive gallows where they executed no fewer than three people, the most famous being Yankee Jim Robinson. And Mr. Whaley actually witnessed Yankee Jim's execution here. That didn't dissuade him from building his house here. And Yankee Jim got blamed later on when the family moved in for the disembodied footsteps that were frequently heard. The Whaley House has appeared in countless books, magazines, newspaper articles, television shows, and even a motion picture. It has been called the most haunted house in America by Life Magazine and the Travel Channel, among others, but the very first person to call it that was the ghost hunter Hans Holzer back in 1964 when he visited here.
In the 1960s, my father, the famous ghost hunter and parapsychologist Dr. Hans Holzer, visited the Whaley House, and what he thought would be a basic case of a grade A haunting, one or two ghosts in questions, turned out to be a very, very layered case of many hauntings and different timelines, not just in the house itself, but on the property. This then turned into what my father said was the most haunted house in North America. And as a result of his investigation, he put this place on the map. Personally, as a ghost hunter myself and an intuitive investigator, I strongly feel and believe, as my father before me, that people should go and visit the Whaley House because it really is steeped in storied history that is fact-checked and based on truth. And there are so many happenings there that you are sure to walk in there one way and walk out very differently. Anybody who wants to know what a real haunted house is all about, the Whaley House is exactly that.
When people come to visit us at the Whaley House, we have several different options for tours. Our regular daytime tours are always self-guided. This gives you the ability to explore the house on your own and take as much time as you would like. We give you a tour sheet that describes the rooms, gives a little of the history, a little of the mystery, and we have wonderful, wonderful storytelling docents to answer any questions you might have. We also offer tours for school groups, senior centers, and we have evening tours. Get things a little more exciting at night. Our evening tours, depending on the season, may be guided, they may be self-guided. Both have their advantages. Guided tours, the guide leads you through the house and tells you about each of the rooms. Self-guided, it's much like the daytime. We have storytelling docents who will engage you in the theater and in the courtroom and throughout the house, and it's a lot of fun. We also offer private after-hours evening tours, where you and a fellow docent will explore behind-the-scenes areas of the museum, be able to enter rooms that are generally partitioned off and have a completely different experience.
The Whaley House was nearly torn down in the 1950s, but thanks to a local group of historic preservationists, it was saved and purchased by the County of San Diego and turned into this lovely museum that you see today. Today it is operated by Save Our Heritage Organization, or SOHO, and you can support our mission of historic preservation in San Diego by taking a tour of the Whaley House, buying a souvenir in the shop, joining our organization, or even volunteering at the Whaley House as a docent.